give himself a little bit of encouragement. The attack from Aoki.
There's that flying knee again. That is getting timed very well. But look at this. He's able to shrug.
Oh, and the knee to the head as well. Punches to the head. The noise behind me is deafening. For Liang looking for the finish. Shinya Aoki is standing very, very closely, watching hard. Nothing's coming back from Aoki. We're only half a minute into this third round. It's perpetual motion from the Filipino. And it is all over. We have a new ONE Championship lightweight title holder.
Liang had those high-risk moves, the spinning kicks, the spinning, and he actually attempted that jump knee once or twice earlier in the fight. And you knew that if it landed, it was going to pay off for him, and it paid off right there.
You can see from the replay, Aoki offering nothing in return, defending as best he could, but nothing was coming back.
Powerful left against 10 for Marek Gafurov. Maverick is a striker from Team Petrosian, meaning that week in, week out, he is sparring with the greatest kickboxer in history, Giorgio Petrosian. Marek Gafurov, if he gets Lapikus to ground, if he takes Lapikus' back, he'll look to slap on his favorite rear naked chop. But he's got to find a way to get past the striking of Yuri Lapikus.
Lapikus is putting everything into these shots. But I gotta say, look at the size of Gafurov. He is gigantic. How did he ever make 70 kilos? But look at him, starting to kick those legs. But he gets close to the Cobra, and the Cobra strikes, locks up that body lock.
Oh, smack dang on the canvas, beautifully down from Yuri Lapikus. Takes the back. Can he reunite to try Gafurov? This would be insane. This would be crazy. This would be awesome.
Gafurov's not even trying to defend.
Is it going to turn?
Is that a tag?
It's over. Yuri Lapikus, you monster.
Nothing he can do. The squeeze was so tight. He slept him. Look at this beautiful throw. Might have threw him on his head because he didn't even defend. Look at this squeeze by Lapikus. What a statement in the lightweight division. Cameron Eversov nice and light on his feet, trying to circle. I like how he's circling to the weak side of Cameron, of Okami. Nice little change of levels there by Okami to get the body lock. I like how he's utilizing those uppercuts to create a little separation.
Cameron Eversov, unfazed by the takedown that Okami got off the clinch, goes back to the clinch himself. He believes that he has the advantage in the clinch, I believe.
Long punches. He just can't seem to keep coming when he throws out those punches, especially that left hand.
Abasov, a lot more lighter on the feet this round. He wants to use his explosiveness. He knows that Okami is staying a little bit more sharp. Landing his straight punches, Abasov is looking to loop over. There you go, loops over with a right hand. Lands on Okami. Okami is hurt. Abasov following up with some left.
Cameron Eversov swarming right now, dropping the ground and pad. The referee jumps in and stops it.
What a victory for Cameron Eversov.
Cameron Eversov lands the big right hand, hurts the Japanese legend.
Beautifully done. Check it out. Talk us through
Let's
this.
Let's look at the
Suba.
Replay here. Cameron Eversov was light on his feet the whole second round. Bounced right into an explosive right hand that hurts Okami. And then follows up with some left hands. Olivier Coste had to stop the bout. Okami was not intelligently defending himself anymore. Here's the right hand again. Okami got caught pulling his head back a little bit too high, and Abasov finds that right hand at home.
And Angela Lee, left hook early from Zhang, go to the body. Lee eats a left, overhand right from Zhang. Xiong Jing Nan fakes the front kick off the back leg, circles off to her left. Angela looking to control center circle, maybe press Zhang back. Leg kick there from Angela. Oh, Xiong Jing Nan trying for a hammer fist strike and a short left hook. Angela presses her against the fence.
This is where Angela's very dangerous now. She's got that body lock and she's also got that underhook on that side. She's gonna try to press in. She's probably looking for a body lock takedown. She's looking to clasp her hands and spin Xiong Jing Nan back down to her backside.
Who will emerge? The Women's Atomweight World Champion. in 4 minutes and 10 seconds time. Will Xiong Jing Nan make history as a two-division world champion? Will Angela Lee defend in a division where she has been unstoppable?
Good defense from Xiong Jing Nan to work her way back away from the circle wall. She's trying to swim and get that underhook on the left side. That she does. Now she gets the body lock. Let's see if she can change the trajectory of this clinch and spin Angela Lee against the circle wall. No, she chooses to separate.
Xiong Jing Nan smiles and nods at Angela. You feel something big is coming from Xiong Jing Nan's hands very soon.
Man, something big's grown on the side of Xiong Jing Nan's head, though.
It's got its own zip code. Body shot there from Xiong Jing Nan. Angela, patient though, picking her openings, trying to thread the jab here, Angela Lee. Left hook, right hand. Need a bit more start behind it there.
Once she has that body lock on, it's a bad spot for Xiong Jing Nan. Angela Lee's got the back now. Let's see if she can dig in that second hook.
Halfway through the fifth and final round, Angela Lee giving it her all. And once again, Xiong Jing Nan needs to defend against a lady with a 78% finishing rate with 6 submissions in 9 wins.
You can see Angela Lee's trying to cradle that leg, trying to separate, possibly go for a banana split. This is where Angela Lee is so dangerous. She's got so many different submission opportunities. One of the owners of the only twister ever seen in one championship. See what she decides to do here. She's trying to pull up that arm so she can slide that hook in. Xiong Jing Nan doing a good job of defending that hook. Angela Lee might not even need the second hook to secure a submission lock here.
They will be going.
I think she's gonna try to take that arm, lace it around her head, look for a twister.
They'll be going absolutely crazy in Hawaii at the moment on TNT for Angela Lee. Taking her time, a strike, and that was a wicked one above the left ear of Xiong Jing Nan. Again, Kinley calls for the elbow, and Angela throws it. Again, the corner calling for elbows and punches from Angela. Still has the back of the strawweight world champion, does the atomweight world champion. The rivalry between these two, like nothing else in one championship. Tremendous respect for each other, but also a tremendous desire to triumph.
What's the difference between the judges' scorecards right here, Michael?
Can Xiong find a way back to her feet? What's Angela looking for now, Dragon?
She's trying to separate. She's trying to take Xiong Jing Nan's left right arm, wrap it around her head, possibly look for a twister. But Xiong Jing Nan's wise to it. She's not allowing it to happen. But that was enabling Angela Lee to get both hooks into the legs there of Xiong Jing Nan. Now she's trying to pound her out. She's got 34 seconds.
Xiong Jing Nan has never been beaten in one championship. Angela Lee choosing her mark, measuring her punches.
Oh, it's underneath.
Now for the choke.
Is that it?
Is this it?
18 seconds to go.
Is it over?
What's underneath?
Do not sleep on Timofey Nastyukhin. The man possesses some extraordinary power. But can he land on Alvarez here? Chance in the semi-finals of the lightweight Grand Prix to meet Lowentay Nanez. Lots of movement early on here from Nastyukhin.
Nastyukhin was able to connect with a nice little straight right hand. It's way for Eddie Alvarez to try to blitz in, throw those combinations, and then get out. When he blitzes in, that's going to be Nastyukhin's chance to land with that big right hand.
Punching right hand there from Nastyukhin. Got to be careful not to leave himself exposed when he overextends like that. Alvarez fakes the right hand. Controlling center cage here, the underground king. Looping left hand from Nastyukhin. Changing levels is Eddie. Just seeing what the Russian has to offer. Big outside leg kick from Alvarez. Not following through with that. Right hand there, Nastyukhin. Goes for the outside lead thigh of Alvarez. Alvarez circling off to his right. Chance go on for Eddie. They love him here in Japan. Made his name competing in Dream. Says he was super excited to return to the land of the rising sun. Nastyukhin's right hand cocked and ready.
Like the change in levels from Alvarez, he's immediately getting Nastyukhin to think about the takedown. If Nastyukhin gets comfortable, like he did with Amir Khan, like he did with Koji Ando, he's able to put together some brilliant performances. Eddie Alvarez needs to mix things up. He can't just stand there and strike with Nastyukhin. He's got to wrestle with him.
Alvarez outside pocket, straight right hand down the center there from Nastyukhin. And Alvarez smiles at him, but he felt that one.
Nice little catch to the right hand from Nastyukhin.
Perfectly placed catch and count. Another good right hand there from Timofey Nastyukhin. Alvarez not wanting to give up center cage here. Adding some little angles is the Underground King. 2 minutes 45 remains. First round of three of this lightweight quarterfinal. Lots of instructions coming from the Russians in the corner of Nastyukhin.
Eddie Alvarez says he spent a lot of time working on his footwork and his speed for this match. He feels he's going to have the advantage in that area, the speed aspect.
Alvarez said that a punch would wobble Nastyukhin, and then he'd finish him with a submission. Nice right hand again from Timofey Nastyukhin on the upswing there with the uppercut, Eddie Alvarez. Some damage already under the right eye of Alvarez. Nothing too serious though for the Underground King. A punt kick there from him. Uppercut again from Alvarez. Back to center cage. Long reach on the right hand there from Eddie. Nastyukhin goes down the center corridor. Nice fancy footwork to get out of dodge from Alvarez. Goes to the body. Clipped upstairs by the lead hand there from Nastyukhin. Quick release on the punches tonight from Timofey Nastyukhin. Usually loads them up a lot more, Nastyukhin, but he's chosen to go for speed and precision over a barrel full of power tonight.
You see, when Eddie Alvarez tries to get nice and tight, that's when Nastyukhin is able to land that right hand.
Alvarez fakes. Nastyukhin, good front kick, dug the balls of the feet into the midsection of Alvarez. That's what you want to do when you throw the front kick, splay the toes out, point the balls of the feet out and drive it into the stomach, into the chest of your opponent. Body shot there from Alvarez. Just over a minute remaining on Eddie Alvarez's one championship debut. A flipping left hand there from Nastyukhin. He tagged him with the underhand. Here comes Nastyukhin. And here's how it happened.
Nastyukhin was able to close that distance, get Eddie Alvarez against the cage, and then it was the big right hand over the guard. I think Eddie blocked that, and Nastyukhin was still able to connect with that right hand. That is how much power Nastyukhin has in those punches. It is a dangerous game plan to stand and bang with Timofey Nastyukhin.
Look at the right hand smack bang to the side of the head of Eddie Alvarez. Nastyukhin just unloading on a hapless Alvarez.
Hey guys, it's Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.